Hello everyone, I'm Isan. In this video, we'll look at two of the latest app updates in the Galaxy Labs. In 2021, apart from adding some new features for applications that already existed in previous version, there are also two new applications added in this new update. The application is called Thermal Guardian and Memory Guardian. Okay, now let's just see what are the new features in this application, how to install it, and what is the function of this latest application. If you haven't tried installing Good Lock app on your Samsung phone yet, you can check out our previous video at the link in the upper right corner. For those of you who have successfully installed Good Lock, you just need to add the Memory Guardian and Thermal Guardian application. In this latest update, you can't find it in the Nice Lock application like in the previous video. For Thermal Guardian and Memory Guardian, you have to install it via Nice Lock. So you can first install the Find Lock application, and after downloading the Find Lock application, you can immediately open the application and click on the icon in the upper right corner, then click on Updates Available. And on the website, you can directly click the home icon in the upper right corner. Then here, you just have to scroll and look for the Thermal Guardian module and the latest Memory Guardian. Here you just need to click, for example, the Memory Guardian, then you just need to download the APK in this section and click download at the bottom. Then wait until the download process is complete. After the download process is complete, you can really open the application and install the application, then click done, and you can directly download the second application called Thermal Guardian. You only need to follow the same method as before and install the application immediately. Then you can immediately close and then open the application via the Nice Lock app. Because the icon is not yet available on Find Lock application in this lab section. So we have to open the settings via Nice Lock. Then after we have finished installing Thermal Guardian and Memory Guardian, now we can open the application. First, let's try this Thermal Guardian application. The application is quite simple. Here you can see the threshold and CPU in the top menu tab. For the thermal threshold, you can set it in this section. For the standard usage, you can just lower it for the thermal CPU. And if you want the maximum CPU speed, you can swipe to the far right. In the notification section, it says if you turn it on to the maximum, the CPU will go up by about 200 Celsius. If you want the default thermal threshold, you can choose the middle one. So for the Thermal Guardian setting, there is only a settings in this thermal threshold. And in the tab view on the right, you can see the thermal CPU. For the graph, you can see the history in the previous hours. If, for example, the temperature of the CPU exceeds the threshold that we have set on the left, the CPU speed will be slowed down a bit to reduce the heat temperature in the CPU if it is excessive. So this is a function of the threshold on the left. If you set it to maximum, the threshold will be slightly higher than the default. So the CPU will work harder than if you set to default or to the far left. So if you want the CPU to work more optimal, you can install this application and set it to the far right. Maybe this works better for those of you who want maximum performance when playing heavy games so that the CPU will work harder and maybe a little bit harder than before. And for those of you who want a normal use, you can choose the default one. This is the default settings. And for CPU usage that is not too heavy, you can set the threshold to the left. So later, the threshold for the maximum running CPU will be lower than usual. So the work of the CPU will be limited and will not work too hard, and will slightly lower the temperature of the CPU. So the CPU temperature will not be too hot if you set it to the far left. So the Thermal Guardian function is only to set this thermal threshold and to monitor CPU performance. And for the settings of Thermal Guardian application function, there is only this in this section. For others, there is only data that you can see. The blue part is the CPU. Then the temperature is the red one. Then let's also try the second feature in the Memory Guardian section. The Memory Guardian function is quite similar to the function of device care settings section on your smartphone. In the settings section on battery and device care, you can also see the setting in the memory section. Here you can select clean now, and you can also select any application that you want to clean from the RAM memory. However, with the addition of this Memory Guardian application, there are some things that are not in the default application earlier. Here the details of the application look clearer than in the device care section earlier. Here you can only see a view application that appear here. While in this Memory Guardian application, you can choose the application in more detail one by one. Here you can select which application one by one that you want to clean the RAM. and which ones you don't want to clean the memory for the smartphone settings. You can also set the excluded apps at the bottom, and you can also select the application individually one by one. And all applications will appear in this section. In addition, here there is also a history tab settings on the right. Here you can see the RAM capacity that is being used. The purple ones are the cache file for the RAM, the yellow ones are the running RAM that's being used, and the red ones are the RAM used for the Android system. As for the free RAM, is the gray one at the top. For maximum performance, you can keep this RAM not exceeding the 80% limit of its maximum capacity. If for example your RAM usage is above 80% continuously in this section, you can reboot or restart the device, or you can immediately force-stop application that you don't use. Here you can also check the history of RAM usage for previous states. So this Memory Guardian application can help you to clear RAM in more detail and also check the history of RAM usage on your smartphone. So the functions of this Memory Guardian application is to manage RAM on your smartphone and also monitor RAM usage on your smartphone in more detail than the device care settings on your smartphone. In addition to addition of these two new applications, there are also new updates from previous application for the lab section. For example, in the battery tracker section for this battery tracker application, it gets an update with a new look. And here you can see the history of battery usage in more detail than the previous version. The features are similar to the functions in the device settings section. As a result, the usage history looks clearer in this battery tracker application. Here we can also set the time period to check the application usage. For example, you want to check from 1 PM to 1 AM. Here we can immediately see the use of the application within the hours that we have set. And we can't set the settings in the device care section. So to monitor battery usage, the battery tracker application gets a pretty interesting update with clearer details. Then for the app booster application, you can also use it to optimize the application usage. You can use the Galaxy App Booster application after upgrading the OS or update to the latest One UI version. Then after that, you can just use it maybe once a week to maximize the performance of your smartphone. When you press optimize now, some apps may have to be reopened when you use them later. The process is also quite time consuming. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to like and also subscribe to get a notification when there is a new video from this channel. If you have further questions, you can directly write them in the comment section or ask directly in Telegram channel, or you can directly DM us to our Instagram account @suntertainment. I hope you get some value out of this video. See you on the next one.